Okay, folks, here we've got the Inkbird Bluetooth Wi-Fi Smart Barbecue Thermometer box. It's got 2.4 or 5G support. Really comes in a nice little box. Let's open it up. First thing you're going to see is the instruction manual. Then you're going to see the actual unit. I advise charging it up. It charges up with a USB cable, C. Then you got some holders for the probes to put in your barbecue pit. Okay, now you gotta somehow get this little box out of here. As you can tell, this is live. Here's the little box. Open it up and you'll find a surprise in there. It's actually part that you need. And it is cables. You got one cable for the ambient temperature and the rest are probes to plug into meat and different things. Now here's the book. It's got everything you want to need, everything you want to know, and more. It's actually pretty straightforward. You know, if you've ever hooked up anything with Bluetooth or Wi-Fi, this is a easy thing to do, okay? So, that's it. And then you're going to put your phone on. Ooh, that was me. And there you go to Google or iPhone store. Get the the Inkbird app. Okay? This is the first time I downloaded this one. I had the other Inkbird thermometer or Bluetooth barbecue thermometer. This is a new one for me. Okay, once you get it, you can open it. Open the app. Turn on the thing first because we're going to sync them up, okay? Try to at least. There, it's on. Okay, now you go back to where you're on the top right there, and then you're gonna do a couple things here. Actually, you gotta open an account and put in a password, and then you're gonna need to know your Wi-Fi passwords and all that, okay? So just bear with me because I wasn't sure what to do at this point, but then I realized oh yeah, so you're gonna look for the device, and there's a picture of it. It's right there. IBT 26S 5G. Push on that. Click next step. Confirm. Tell it it's okay to use it. This is all Android stuff. Turn it on. And then searching for it. It might not find it right away. You might have to wait a little bit. Or you can stop it and start it again. Mine took a little bit. And there, it made it, see? Push the power button, come on. Then it found it right there. Just keep going. Right there, this is where I didn't put in my code for the Wi-Fi and it kind of got stuck, so I had to go back and put in my code, which, oh well. So this is a step that didn't go too good. Let me pause. Alrighty. There it is. Got two of them. Let's just pick one of the two. Why not? Finally popped up, you know. There, and it's going to tell you. And then what you do, you just wait till it connects, okay? No biggie. And get your probes ready now. Okay, so it's not going to show any temperatures till you plug those in, just to let you know. You might want to plug them in first. I didn't realize that. Which pretty straightforward there. Now it's in Celsius, so I'm gonna have to change it in a minute here. Cause I'm in United States. We don't use that. All right, so there we have it. Okay, now here we're in the menu. Go to Fahrenheit, that should have changed it. There, now we're room temperature because I haven't tested it on anything yet. So they should both be pretty close. they are. Here's the other things that's in there. If you want to see all of them, they're all there. All right, now we got some boiling water and some ice water. And this is the app here on the phone. So we got 207 and 33, very close. And that should read exactly the same as the unit. That's getting hot. It's not quite there. It's starting to rapid boil. And the probe has to touch an ice cube to get it very close. So, see, 32 degrees. That's freezing. So that's perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. And 210 and 211 and 212, that's all around boiling point of water. This is the best way to check any thermometers that you might have. Is with boiling water and ice. You're gonna get your two extremes, okay? Because you're not gonna go over boiling in anything, probably maybe oil, but to calibrate it and just to check it. And as far as I can tell, this is perfect. So I'm very happy with it. Thumbs up, good job, Inkbird, and we'll be checking it out in the future.